Welcome to the ninth video of the second module, that is conformal transformation and complex integration. In this video I am taking the second tutorial, that is problems on bilinear transformation. So find the bilinear transformation which maps z1 is equal to 1, z2 is equal to 0, z3 is equal to 1 into W1 is equal to 0, W2 is I and W3 is equal to 3I. So let us name respectively as Z1 is 1, Z2 is 0, Z3 is 1 into W1 is 0, W2 is I, W3 is equal to 3I. So we have by the formula W minus W1 into W2 minus W3 by W1 minus W2 into W3 minus W is equal to Z minus Z1 into Z2 minus Z3 by Z1 minus Z2 into Z3 minus Z. Let us replace the values of W1, W2, W3 and Z1, Z2, Z3 in the appropriate places. So we get W minus 0 into I minus 3I by 0 minus I into 3I minus W is equal to Z plus 1 into 0 minus 1 by minus 1 minus 0 into 1 minus Z. Here this minus 1 and minus 1 will be cancelled in the numerator, or else this minus can be cancelled over here. Z plus 1 divided by 1 minus Z, we get it. And in the left hand side we get W into I minus 3I will be minus 2I, and in the denominator we have minus I, then into 3I minus W. Here also minus and minus can be cancelled and even I and I can be cancelled. The next step would be 2W divided by 2W divided by 3I minus W is equal to Z plus 1 divided by 1 minus Z. Let us cross multiply, then we get it as 2W into Z 1 minus Z is equal to 3I minus W into Z plus 1. On multiplication, 2W minus 2WZ is equal to 3IZ plus 3I minus WZ minus W. Taking all the W terms to the left hand side, we get 3W minus WZ is equal to 3IZ plus 3I. And in the left hand side, again we are taking W common, then we get W is equal to 3IZ plus 3I divided by minus Z plus 3. Or we can again take 3I common in the numerator, which gives us Z plus 1 divided by minus Z plus 3. This is the required bilinear transformation. Next problem. Previously, all the problems we discussed with only the constants or the values, which is finite values. Whereas in this case, we can observe what to do when we have taken Z as infinity, any one of the point as infinity, either in the Z or in the W, how it has to be determined, and also find the fixed point of the transformation. So as usual, we will take the values of Z1, Z2, Z3 as respectively infinity, I and 0, W1, W2, W3 as minus 1, minus I and 1. We have the formula. Substitute the values in their respective places. But here, before substituting in the Z place we have one of the value as infinity, that is Z1. Therefore, we will take this Z1 outside, which has got infinity. We will take that Z1 outside. Then this Z1 and that one cancels. We get Z divided by Z1. Anything divided by infinity will become 0. So here we can see this Z1 and Z1 cancels. Z by infinity minus Z1 replaced with a 1 and Z3 is replaced with 0. All the values are replaced in this step. Only thing we should observe here is wherever the infinity value comes, that term needs to be taken to the outside and then it will be cancelled both in the numerator and denominator. So that this z divided by infinity, even if w side also if infinity comes, that particular one should be taken outside and then cancelled in the same manner. Now, next step, this implies minus of w plus 1 into I plus 1 divided by 1 minus w into I minus 1 is equal to minus I divided by minus z. Or cancelling this minus and minus, here what happens is minus of w plus 1 in the left hand side we already have minus. Minus of w plus 1 into I plus 1 z is equal to I into 1 minus w into I minus 1. On multiplication, minus wzi minus wz minus iz minus z is equal to minus 1 minus I plus w plus iw. That is, by multiplying minus sign on both the sides, we get wzi plus wz plus w plus iw is equal to minus zi plus z plus 1 plus I. Taking the w in the left hand side, what remains is I plus 1 into z plus I plus 1 is equal to minus of I plus 1 into z plus I plus 1. Here, the I plus 1 we can divide it throughout I plus 1, which is common on either side, can be divided. So, directly we can get this step. W is equal to 1 minus z divided by 1 plus z. That is what we will be getting. This is the required bilinear transformation. Now we'll see to the invariant points or the fixed points. In order to find the fixed points, we need to put w is equal to z in the obtained bilinear transformation. Thereby, we get z is equal to minus z plus 1 divided by z plus 1. This implies z square plus z is equal to minus z plus 1. Or it leads to the equation by the quadratic equation z square plus 2z minus 1. Now, by applying the formula minus b plus or minus b square minus 4ac under the root divided by 2a, if you apply that, we get minus 2 plus or minus root 8 divided by 2. That is, minus 1 plus or minus of root 2. So, the fixed points are given by minus 1 plus root 2 and minus 1 minus root 2. These are the fixed points which is required for the bilinear transformations. Next problem. As we have seen in the previous problem, z was taken, one of the point of z was taken as infinity, and now we can see in the w points we have taken w3 as infinity. The same way we have to work it out. So, the solution is, let us consider z1, z2, z3 respectively as I, 1 and minus 3 and w1, w2, w3 as 1, 0 and infinity. As I told you, this w3 has the infinity, so it needs to be eliminated in the left hand side. So, we will take w3, we will consider the formula first. And wherever W3 is there, that needs to be eliminated. So, we will take W3 outside from the second term in the left hand side. Similarly, in the denominator also. Thereby, this W3 and W3 will be cancelled. And anything divided by W3, that means infinity, will become 0. So, here W minus 1. After this step, we are going to substitute the values of Z1, Z2, Z3 and W1, W2 and W3. Thereby, we get w minus 1 into 0 by infinity minus 1 divided by 1 minus 0 into 1 minus w by infinity. Anyway, anything divided by infinity will be equal to 0. So, it leads to 0. Next, in the right hand side, z minus I into 1 plus 1 divided by I minus 1 into minus 1 minus z. This is what we are getting. Next, let us do the simplification. So, on simplification, we get w minus 1 into minus 1 divided by 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 into z minus I divided by I minus 1 into z plus 1. Let us cross multiply and then do the simplification. So we get wzi plus wi minus wz minus w minus zi minus I plus z plus 1 is equal to 2z minus 2i. Now in the left hand side, retain only the w terms and transfer the remaining terms to the right hand side. Then we take w outside, we get I minus 1 into z plus I minus 1 is equal to 2z minus 2i plus zi plus I minus z minus 1. On simplification in the right hand side, what do we get is z minus I plus zi minus 1. And in the left hand side, we have w into I minus 1 into z plus 1. So here what happens is I plus 1 into z minus of 1 plus I. We can take again 1 plus I outside, thereby we get z minus 1. So in the left hand side also we can take the I minus 1 outside, thereby we get z plus 1, and here z minus 1 into I plus 1. Therefore the w is equal to I plus 1 into z minus 1 divided by I minus 1 into z plus 1. Now multiply this by its conjugate, as the denominator should not have any I part, the imaginary part. Therefore we are multiplying it. Then what we are getting is I plus 1 into I minus 1 into z minus 1 divided by I minus 1 the whole square, and I squared minus 1 into z minus 1 divided by minus 1 plus 1 minus 2i into z plus 1. Further on simplification, we can cancel this minus 2 and minus 2. Then we get z minus 1 divided by I into z plus 1, where 1 upon I can be written as minus I. Therefore, and again taking this minus sign outside, we can also write it as 1 minus z. Therefore, we get z is w is equal to I into 1 minus z divided by 1 plus z. This is the required bilinear transformation. And this is the problem where in the w side also we have taken the infinity, whereas in the previous problem we have taken the z side as infinity. Next problem. Find the bilinear transformation which maps z is equal to infinity I 0 to w is equal to 0 I infinity. You can observe here in this problem both the sides we have got one point as infinity. So same rule is applicable even in this problem also. As usual, we will consider z points as z1, z2, z3 and w points as w1, w2 and w3. Here in the z point we have z1 is infinity, and in the w, w3 is infinity. So wherever z1 is there and w1 is there, we need to, w3 is there, we need to eliminate it, and thereby we get in this format after substitution. So we get w into minus 1 divided by minus I into 1 is equal to minus 1 into I divided by 1 into minus z. So everywhere we have minus sign, so it will be cancelled with the negative sign. Then we get w by I is equal to I divided by z. This is the simplest form we are getting. Again, by taking the I here, what we are getting is I square divided by z or minus 1 divided by z. So you can observe here w is equal to I square divided by z or minus 1 upon z. So w is equal to minus 1 upon z. This is the required bilinear transformation we are going to get it. Thank you.